This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Today is a gift, for we have victory in Jesus. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for this evening and your great blessings of today. We thank you that your mercies are new every morning. And God, tonight we receive that as we spend this time together in celebration of these great words, these great songs, and these great psalms, Lord. And our aim tonight is that you become famous all over this world through our worship and through our praise through music. We give you this time tonight, and we thank you in advance. In Christ's name, amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
commercial airliners took off to their scheduled destinations across the United States. Shortly thereafter, all four were hijacked. Two were intentionally flown into the Twin World Trade Centers in New York City, and one into the Pentagon in Arlington, Virginia, killing everyone on board. The hijackers took over the cockpit of the fourth plane and diverted it toward the Capitol or to the White House for its devastation. Two 30-year-old passengers, Todd Beamer, assembled the passengers and stormed the cockpit in order to crash the plane to abort. The hijackers' plan of destruction to Washington, D.C. Just before yelling the now famous instruction, "Let's roll," Todd Beamer, a devout Christian, led the group in the Lord's Prayer and this timeless psalm of comfort. Within 5 minutes, Flight 93 hit the ground at Shanksville, Pennsylvania, at 580 miles per hour. All 44 passengers died. We dedicate this psalm tonight, chosen by Todd Beamer, as some of the last words uttered by these brave folks to them, as well as thousands of others who lost their lives in September on the 11th, 2001. Psalm 23 says, "Surely goodness and surely mercy."
Prepare a table. our cry tonight, that we would come alive in Christ Jesus. That the dead bones of complacency, not really wanting to get involved, saying we can't do this, we can't do that, I don't feel like it. I think about those people on the plane. They have no choice. No choice at all. You have a choice. They had no choice. There was no way out. They were captive. They were captive in that plane with no solution. There was nothing they could do. They were helpless. Helpless. And they knew the end was near. You know how the Bible says, no man knows the day nor the hour. I'm sure when they woke up in the morning, they never thought that that day, September 11th, would be that day. He's calling for us, the church, who are free. Who are free to come alive, to serve him while we have a chance, to be a blessing to those all around us, just like he's a blessing to us. Jasper started off by saying, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. This is the day for you to come along. Today is a gift from God for all of us. He has given us another day for what? For us to dine together? For us to have parties? All those things are good and wonderful. But our mission is to serve him and to be a witness to him. To be a witness to those who don't know Christ as a personal Savior. I can imagine how the angels were flying around that plane, comforting. And even as they said the Lord's Prayer together, I believe the Lord was just simply said, it's all right. It's all right. It's all right. It's just like being in a car accident. You see it coming, and there's nothing you can do. You're on black ice, and your car is sliding. There is nothing, absolutely nothing you can do, except cry out to them, which they did. You know, I often think about those families, the families who are still living, who have to remember every September, you know. I often think about that. I know exactly where I was on September 11th. Do you know where you were? You know exactly where you were when that awful thing happened. So our hearts still go out to those families. Our hearts still go out to our nation. Our hearts go out in praise to God for how he is still supporting the hurting, those who are. What will you do with the gift that you've given? The gift of salvation that he's given you, what will you do with it? Will you share it with others? Will you tell the good news? Will you loudly proclaim it as we've done tonight, everywhere you go? That is our mission. You know, a gift is no good until you give it. I mean, you can buy all kinds of Christmas gifts, put them in the closet. Christmas Day comes, you lock the closet and don't take them out. Wrap them real nice, and there they are. A gift you are a person that can speak peace in the midst of a plane that is going down. You're right there, speaking peace and comfort. Eyes are closed, and we pray. We pray that there's no long-term suffering. And now we pray for us, Lord, that when the plagues from the enemy comes into our lives to tear us down, we pray that you would raise up a standard against the fiery plagues of the enemy on our behalf. And help us to keep serving you. We give you praise and honor and glory. Thank you for that reminder tonight that you created this day for us to serve you. And we will do just that in Christ's name. Amen. He gives the gift of salvation, and then he says, just oh Lord, just wait a minute. I got something even better. He says, I go to prepare a place for you. Oh, I go to fix up your place. Thank God for that. So this is not all there is, the sufferings of this world. He says, I've got something for you. We long to see the light of that city. He has done for me, he's done great things for you. Let's go share those great things. Let's give the gifts that he's given us. Whatever he's given you, use it for God's benefit. Share the good news everywhere you go. Sometimes it's only a smile. Walking past someone, that smile can change their lives. Thank you for being with us tonight. Who's here tonight for the first time? Thank you for being here tonight. We appreciate any time you people come. Thank you. Come, you're more than welcome to come back. Often. As a matter of fact, every second Sunday we are in this building giving praise to the King of Kings. And we'll be back the next time on October the 14th. Please join us. May God go with you. May he bless you. May he watch out for you. May he protect you along the highway. And may he clarify to you your mission for him. Thank you, Lord, for what you will do through us in Christ's name. Amen. Amen. Good night, everybody. Thank you for being with us.